Good morning, YouTubers. Thank you very much for taking your time to join me today. Late last night, at about 7:05 p.m. Central Daylight Time, there was a magnitude 6.2 earthquake by Papua New Guinea. USGS listed it as about 260 kilometers or 162 miles east-southeast of Biak, Indonesia. I'm probably slaughtering that name. There was no tsunami warning, and going to Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. And this area has had large earthquakes. In 2015, there was a magnitude 7.0. Earlier in the same location, there was a magnitude 5.5 and a 5.9 that USGS downgraded. They revised them. There was actually two earthquakes of a magnitude 6.2. Here's the one location, and there's the other location. I downloaded data from two different monitors. Here is the first 6.2 that occurred. There's its signature. And the one monitor, for some reason, data stopped coming in for quite a few hours right after the other 6.2. Let's see if I can find it here. No, that's not it. All right, there's a lot of earthquakes on here. A lot of them are not being reported. Let me make this one larger here, and we'll take a look at the different earthquakes. Okay, this one was at 21:39. They're saying it was probably a 4.9 near Bandan Sea, which is off over here. I don't think they're fudging about the size of this earthquake. I get a magnitude 4.91. You can see there at the bottom. And then the next one, let's pull it back up. I'll have to close that out. Would be right here. Let's see, 23:34. That is the first of two 6.2s. 11.2 miles in depth. Yeah, and this is when the data shortly afterwards cut off. You can see it's between 1 and maybe 6 hertz. Let's look at the seismic signature here. And as you know, this is all part of the ring of fire. We got the plates moving. If I can make this bigger, it doesn't want to get bigger. And because of the tectonic plate movement, the ring of fire, you have a lot of volcanoes in this area. I'm going to go to the other monitor because this one was actually working. It was farther away. And I'm going to use Google Earth and show you how far it is away. Yeah, quite a ways away. I haven't listed this station yet. I'm going to have to put it there so I have it, the network and all that, for future use. All right, let's bring it out. And, yeah, okay. I'll bring it in a little bit. It's on the coast, the northern coast of Australia, and this is where these earthquakes have been happening. The other monitor, which is much closer, Port Moresby there in Papua New Guinea, that's the one that stopped working. It would have been a good one, but I'm going to have to put that here on my Google map, so I'll have that for the future for earthquake monitoring too. There's a lot of other monitors closer, but they're not working. Yeah, surprise, surprise, surprise. All right, so let's go over here to what's going on. This is a strange area because we got the Pacific plate slowly moving south, maybe a little bit southwest. You can see here this area that I got drawn out in a pink and yellow line. That is actually where the Pacific plate is actually rising up over Papua New Guinea. But over in this section where these earthquakes have been happening, the Pacific plate is sliding under. And this is the New Guinea trench. You can see the direction that it's moving. You would think within this area there'd be a lot of earthquakes because of the fold. It would have to be fold. One part of the fault line would be higher than, say, over here to the east for it to be subducting underneath. Very unusual. And then, of course, we got the Australian plate, which is moving north. You can see that there. USGS only has 9 earthquakes listed in this area for the last 24 hours. I was looking for, 341, a 4.5. I was looking for probably that one right there. That one was deep. Oh my goodness, 74.1 miles below sea level. And that's it right there on this monitor. That's actually closer to Papua New Guinea. Let's go to the signature. That's the one I was looking for. Yeah, see, we got, yeah, tectonic. Well, we got subduction being that deep. Yeah. 13:37 universal time. You see, this is close to when I finished pulling the files. That one comes in maybe as a magnitude 3.48. Yeah, it's a small one compared to what they've been having. Yeah, and it's subduction too. Look at that. They're not reporting that earthquake, but they are reporting one at 13:49, which I don't, it doesn't really show up on this monitor. And it does not show up on this other monitor. Oops, I gotta close that out. I'm getting all these earthquake notifications. Alright, Alaska's rocking. Okay. Yeah, 12:56. Got a very long P wave on it. Yeah. But it is not being reported. Let me go back and double check again. Let's look at the seismic signature. Yeah, I extended my search zones for all earthquakes. And that one is not being reported in. Yeah, my search area covers a large area. Yeah, there was a 1.4 at 12:50 there in Alaska. But, yeah, so I don't know. It's a nice signature. And you can see the lines of melt. Yeah, we'll go back down here. Yeah, more earthquakes that they're not reporting. And that one actually lasted quite a while. 13:52. Yeah, I don't think it's the 4.9 because the 4.9 was at 13:49, and yeah, that monitor would have picked it up much quicker. So that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.